Hi guys, it's me again. I am going to give this towel smash another try. Thanks to everybody who helped me give their opinion on what it should be named. I didn't know if it should be towel smash, towel dip. But I'm going to do something different with it because I'm going to try it with a wet paper towel instead of a dry one and see if that does anything. So we will see. All right, so I'm going to put a white base on. I probably should have done this before you guys joined me, but for those of you who did not see my last video, I will do it. So this is just regular Artist Loft acrylic mixed with Floetrol and water. And a tiny bit of Liquitex pouring medium. I just put a bit in there just because I think sometimes it helps with the crazing. If I leave too much paint on the canvas, might just be my imagination, but that's how I do it. So I'm just trying to get this over all of the edges so that it's a nice smooth base coat. I might not have enough paint on it, but I don't like to just pour a shit ton of paint and then just pour it right off, you know. Because then I'm really wasting. I mean, it is a lot cheaper than resin. I would never do a base coat of resin like this. I can tell you that. Oops. Too much. See, I didn't want to do exactly what I just did. But all right, cover all my corners, make sure my edges, oops, this edge didn't get covered. Where are my napkins that I... I just put paint all over my laptop. Hang on, let me get that real quick. That's kind of important. If it was the floor or the table, I'd be good. Okay. So I'm going to torch this real quick. Get rid of the bubbles. Come on. All So I'm going to try kind of the same concept, but I'm going to try like different like flowers. So it's not just one big flower in the middle. So I'm going to go here. This is Artist Loft Cerulean Blue. Then I'm going to do You know, sometimes these caps end up leaking and ruining. Okay. This one was Artist Loft. Just flicked it. I'm not having a good day. It was Artist Loft Magenta. And this one's going to be the lemon yellow. And I got something in there. Okay, so I'm going to put some of the yellow in the pink, some in the blue, little bit of blue, little bit of blue, just a tad of pink. Here, so I don't spill them. I'm gonna put this green around them. Now the other day I didn't put them, I put them kind of far out. So I'm trying to get it . Don't have any silicone in these, I don't think. The magenta. Yep, the magenta's got a little silicone in it. You can see the cells forming on the outside. Like different color leaves. Come on. Drip. Oops. So I'm wondering if a wet paper towel is going to make a difference. So we will find out. All right. Let me give it a torch, get the bubbles out before I smash it. Alright, so I've already wet paper towel. So we'll start here and lay it down. And then I'm just gonna smash it. All All right. Corner to corner. Lift it up. Move it down a little bit. Lots of bubbles in it. I gotta pick a paint that doesn't have silicone in it. I mean, it looks kind of crazy. Looks cool. It's gonna level itself out because the Floetrol in it. Wondering if I should dab more flowers. Or if I should leave it be. Of course I'm not going to leave it be. I wouldn't be me if I left it be, right? Who am I, Dr. Seuss? Let's see what we can do. Of course I just messed it up. And I gotta fix that part. And by fix, I mean mess up more. So, because I just screwed that up, I'm going to try something. Anyway, I think that the towel smash worked a little bit better than being wet. So I'm just going to soften the lines here. Just so that it looks like a like it goes together. Just blow out the edges just a bit. This pink one's really looking tie-dye-ish. And if you use a straw or a tube, sometimes collects spit in here from your air or from your breath. So you want to get rid of that. Nobody wants you to spit on their painting. Although these are just practice paintings anyway for me right now. And you don't want to dip your thing like I just did. Okay. So I'm not in love with this. And I should have probably left it alone. But I didn't. So I'm going to dip it again. This time with a dry paper towel. And I'm going to pull it this way because the leaves are here. Ay, ay, ay. So dumb. All right. So here's what we're going to do. We are going to do it again. I'm going to get this. I'm going to. So I have my commission piece drying over there. The first layer. It's making me pretty nervous. Commission piece in itself doesn't make me nervous, but trying to replicate another one of my pieces makes me nervous, because when you're dealing with that was not what I wanted to do. This is why I don't do lives. So when you're trying to replicate one of your pieces, it's just really hard, because especially dealing with resin and, you know, the like fluid acrylics and stuff, like the flower I made yesterday, I really liked it. And you know what, that background, one of the towel flips that turned into the background, is actually really pretty. So I'm going to kind of leave this. No, I'm not. I'm just going to put a little bit of yellow. the background, you can see all these different cells forming. All right. So, gonna do it again. I didn't set it right. Too bad. Too bad. Okay. I got a crease. Hopefully it levels itself out. That one looks kind of cool. My white base paint is already drying. I got this crease here. Hopefully the Liquitex ends up balancing it out. So there you go, guys. Little abstract flowers with the towel smash. All right, let me, I don't know if you've seen it. I don't even know if I'm in camera view. Let's see. Almost looks like sponge painting. All right, so let me get rid of this. I have a little one prepped. Got the paints out, might as well, right? Let me try. I'm gonna try red flower. Red and white flower. Oops. Fill in this canvas like I just did. Makes me want to do a puddle pour now. Making a mess. Making a mess. Okay, we're gonna do some red flowers. Let me dump off some more paint though. because there sure is a lot on there. And I'm going to be making more paint. Or putting more paint on there. Okay. All right, I'm going to do three little red flowers. I'm just going to dot them. See if that works better than a swirl. Seriously, it looks like my nose is bleeding on the canvas. Promise, guys, I'm not bleeding. I'm not bleeding. Just gonna put a little yellow right in the middle. Just because for some reason I think all flowers have to be yellow in the middle. I don't know. Now we're going to put our funky little leaves. I'm actually kind of liking how it is now. It really is a lot of fun playing with acrylics, especially like after doing resin work. Because, I mean, when you do resin work and something doesn't turn out the way that you think it should or the way that you want it to, it really absolutely hurts your heart because it's so expensive. Seriously, guys, I'm really kind of liking this the way it is. Alright, so then with acrylics, it's a little less expensive. Actually, it's a lot less expensive. So, you feel like you can experiment a little bit more, you know? Alright, so, here we go. I'm going to ruin my little flowers now. I'm just moving them back down just a little bit. Let's see. All like different kinds of flowers. What are those? What are those? Are they poppies that I'm thinking of? There you have it. I'll have to do something with this down here because I'm not a big fan of that. But I really like how these are developing. Ooh. You guys see that? Popped up some more cells. Like white fading cells. Alright guys, well there's another attempt at the towel smash. I gotta figure out what to do with these little stems. I might just add more. What a mess of my table. Seriously, Christina Welch would go crazy on me right now. See my flowers. Alright guys, hope you liked playing with me, and I will talk to y'all soon. Thanks.